Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum and a very good evening to Nizam, our beloved lecturer, and my beloved classmates. So today, I would like to present on the situation we heard from last week class.
Tekanlah nak, oi.
Bertenang, eh? Okay, the scenario, eh? Okay, imagine yourself as the CEO of your company. You notice that there is an ongoing conflict between a male and a female top level management. If you let this conflict continue, it would surely have damaging consequences on your company. So the question is, how would you resolve this conflict? What communication strategies would you use to resolve this conflict while ensuring you are not biased towards gender? Okay, one strategy first is one-to-one discussion. One-to-one discussion. This is not to heart-to-heart or face-to-face discussion. First, as a CEO, I will meet person by person. First, I will meet the male, so I would like to hear what is the actual problem. And then I will meet the female, and I would like to hear what is the problem. And from these two people, so I will not going to judge, because we cannot be a gender bias. So I will apply strategies such as I will active listening to them. What is actually the point that lead to the conflict? Okay, the second one is 1-2-2. Means I call both of them inside the meeting room. So I ask them to actually confront what is actually the dissatisfaction between these two people. So again, I will apply active listening to the confrontation. And if the confrontation is become complicated, too heat, so I will interfere. So I will avoid this confrontation becoming too intense. Okay, thank you for the help. And then after listening to the confrontation, and I will start to give feedback. And I start to remind them their function as a top management in the company. First, to remind of them the function of the position in bring business of the company to the media, for example. Because top management conflict is not a small matter to the business. Because nowadays, whenever people, especially top level management, having a conflict, is always, a big issue. It is a big issue. I'm not going to say that word. It's actually No, actually, whenever there is a conflict between the two top management inside the company, there will be a speculation about it, okay? Because whenever the subordinate knows about their boss having a conflict with the other boss, they will be membawang or talk about the issue. So whenever the subordinate knows about the thing, so usually it will go outside of the company, and usually our competitor will start to like, oh, this is a chance for us to actually kill this company business. Okay, the next one is a special bonding session. Okay, during the discussion between these two, we will try to find the common things that they like or they would like to do together. For example, maybe both of them like food, the same food, or the same favorite activities such as karaoke or bowling or golf. So as a CEO, I will spend my time together with them to bring them and spend the time with them and try to get the bonding session with them. Because I believe that bonding is strengthening the relationship, especially on working relationship between these two figures. And last but not least is assign special tasks. Same like previous presenter talking about special tasks, because this is to encourage a good teamwork between them. Yeah. And at the same time, it's promoting togetherness and to strengthen the bonding again, because whenever we assign special tasks, special task, we actually apply collaborating strategy between them, because where there is a special task, they will collaborate and in finding the best solution for the project, and then we are also applying compromising, where both of them have to complete the task, and they have to agree to one solution to make the task completed. I think that's all. In the conclusion, conclusion in Jakarta. Yeah. Gila. The conflict between top management should be resolved immediately, as it is a serious issue. If the CEO did not take appropriate action, it is common when there is a conflict in the top management. The news will be spread immediately among the employees, and the speculation will start to escalate from mouth to mouth. The best approach is to use avoiding. Avoiding is where the CEO immediately taking action when he knows about this conflict. And then collaborating, where, as I said, collaborating where the two parties assigned to a special project. So they actually discuss about what's the best strategy for them to make the project success. So they cannot have too many strategies, because of course they have different strategies. So during this special task, they will discuss and collaborate on one strategy to make the project success. That's all from me. Thank you. Next.